Some classrooms in the province of Cebu remain unusable for the upcoming school year. These were damaged by Typhoon Odette that struck nearly 2 years ago. The principal of Mandawi City Comprehensive National High School says their senior high building is still undergoing repairs. With about 15 classrooms deemed unusable, the 6,000 enrolled students for the new school year will have to go through shifting classes from 6 in the morning to 9 in the evening. The Education Department's Central Visayas Director says they are doing their best to expedite classroom repairs. Meanwhile, several schools in the province of Pampanga are still flooded with just a little over a week before classes start. The Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office says there's still flooding in at least 34 villages. This after the southwest monsoon and consecutive typhoons brought heavy rains to the area.
The Philippine Central Bank leaving its rates unchanged for the third consecutive time. The Banco Central's benchmark rate stayed at 6.25% as it cited continued risks from inflation and a slower economic growth in the second quarter.
Given these considerations, the Monetary Board deemed it appropriate to maintain monetary policy settings to allow a moderation of inflation even as authorities continue to assess the emerging risks to inflation outlook. Authorities, the strength of economic activity going forward is likely as pent-up demand wanes and the full impact of prior monetary policy tightening continues to manifest.
The Banco Central also slightly increased its inflation forecast this year. That's from the 5.5% in May to now at 5.6. Next year, it sees a consumer price index settling at 3.3%, also higher from the earlier 2.8. Thursday's Monetary Board meeting was Governor Eli Remolona's first as central bank chief.
China is reportedly constructing an airstrip on an island being claimed by Vietnam and Taiwan. Satellite images show the ongoing construction of a runway more than 600 meters long on Trident Island in the South China Sea. Trident Island rests at the westernmost and southernmost of the Paracel group of islands. Beijing has historically attempted to assert its claims in the waters by building artificial islands and military facilities.
The Metro Manila Police District says no body cameras were worn during the fatal shooting of 17-year-old Jemboy Baltasar. Its Chief Information Officer Eunice Salas believes the cops failed to wear the body cameras during the hot pursuit operation. She explains the wearing of body cameras are only mandatory during by-bust operations. The former police chief of Navota City earlier said the cops' body cameras ran out of battery.
As far as I know, the body-worn cameras should be used specifically during by-bus operations, arrest of wanted persons, and during the service of search warrant. Uh-huh. All other police operations, they are not really mandatory, but should be used whenever appropriate. Uh-huh. Not justifying their actions, but I believe so because of the continuous pursuit of the suspect, these personnel were not able to use these body-worn cameras. But this will be investigated thoroughly by the Internal Affairs Service and Northern Police District.
The country's top cop denies a quota system is in effect during his watch. This scheme, according to the PNP chief, puts unnecessary pressure to policemen to meet a minimum number of arrests that will form part of their accomplishments. ABS-CBN News' Raya Capulong joins us on the line for details. Raya?
Denise, Philippine National Police Chief General Benjamin Accorda Jr. emphasized that there is no quota system under his leadership. According to the official, whenever there is a pressure to the PNP personnel to make an accomplishment, there is a tendency to be careless in the operations while conviction rates are also low. He said he wants things done according to his five focus agenda, and part of it is being aggressive in intensifying the fight against criminality, but honest. He also emphasized that he has not heard if there is a quota system even before. But in a press briefing last Monday in Camp Crame, according to General Rodel Sermonia, PNP Deputy Chief for Administration, the quota system for police operations was abolished on the directive of ACORDA and Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos. Denise?
Thanks, Raya.